Hi, my name is Robert. This video is designed to give you step-by-step detailed instructions on completing the task at hand. Please read the comments in the About section of this video. It has valuable information and updates. My YouTube channel has a disclaimer video that I encourage you to watch. And please, like, share, and subscribe. I hope you found what you're looking for. Thank you very much for watching. Got the Panther up on the rack. Priority number one, get the rear sway bar in. Priority number three, get the front anti-sway bar in. Let's get started. First thing we're going to do is mark these bolts right here, because you got to take these loose, and marking them may help you get the alignment back close to where it was. So I'm going to get a wire brush, brush that up a little bit, because this car was aligned very close to perfect the other day. And we want to put that back. You got to take this loose to get that anti-sway bar in here. So let me mark this, take them loose, work on getting the anti-sway bar in here. I marked around those with a Sharpie. I'm going to go ahead and pop it loose. 21 millimeter. Might have to hold the top bolts. I got those bolts out. So I should be able to move this bracket around enough to get my anti-sway bar in there. Let me try to see if I can get it in there, and the other side hooks up here, then I'll re-secure that. Sometimes you may have to move your exhaust out of the way. I got one hanger that was already broke, so I may have to take this other hanger loose and maybe the tailpipe, but let's see what happens first. I got it started, maneuvered it up in there, tapped the end of it with a hammer. You see the paint markings? I have it lined up with the hole. I'm going to put these two bolts in, then I'm going to re-secure this mount here on the back. Air bolt in and torque down. Number on top is a 15, bottom is a 19, and on the front one it's a 15 and a 15. Got those two bolts in, 15 15s. Now I need to put my bolts back in my bracket linkage here and tighten those down. I have those bolts set in place. I need to align them so that they're where they were when I removed them, and then tighten them up. And they're all tight. They're 21 on the bottom, 15 on the top. So torque those and you should be good to go. Now the next thing I would do, if I were you, is spray some corrosive proof stuff on these, like undercoating or some thick paint, or put some grease or something on them so they doesn't rust. Took your exhaust loose, put that back on. Needed to get this bushing back in this muffler hanger. I really can't stretch those things around, so I normally take the bracket loose with the 12 millimeter, hook it in, then bolt the bracket back up. That works for me. Next up is the front anti-sway bar, IPD style. I have the brackets here. It's a 24, 25 millimeter anti-sway bar. I got the new bushings, the lubrication, and all. Let's get started. First thing I need to do is take the rack loose from the subframe. I'm going to take that bolt loose there, that bolt loose there, that bolt loose there, come over the other side, that bolt loose there, and that bolt loose there. Then I'm going to take that bolt loose there, and the steering rack will be loose from the bottom of the car. This car just keeps on giving. Now I need to replace a CV axle, or at least rebuild it. The CV axle boot is gone. I don't know if it's a Volvo axle or not, so I'll probably just replace the whole axle. Here you are, I got the sway bar end links loose. I got, those are 15s. Hold it with a 230. I got these 15s loose and that 18 loose. Now I'm gonna knock these 14s off. Then I'm going to loosen the subframe 18s, and that subframe should come down enough for me to get this sway bar out of here. Now you want to make sure you see how the sway bar is routed, because you need to put it back the same way you got it off. I have my subframe hanging down. I'm going to try to sneak a 14 rail on top of those with just the subframe hanging down that far and clean it up a little bit and put the other bar up there, lubricate the bushings and stuff like that. Let's see if I can get it out. I got all four bolts out, lift the brackets up. I was always told that these were sweated on there, but it doesn't look like it. They're just dirty as heck. So, let's see if I can lift this out of there, put it back the way I got it out. Actually, I could disconnect this line right here, just pull it straight out that way. That's mine versus the IPD one. What I did was pull down on the subframe on this side. I could have took the front of it loose a little bit, but I didn't. I forced it out this way, past the inner tie rod in. Then once I got it to hang down, I just worked the other side out. So I'm gonna clean it up a little bit, prep this thing to go in with the lubrication and stuff, and set the IPD bar in place. I ended up using the entire tube of the bushing lube and got this bushing all lubed up and ready to go. Filled it up. Now I'm gonna fit this in there and make sure it's in place. Start my bolts. I'm gonna put it in like I got the other one out. Let me set this down and get started. I tightened down all four sway bar bushing bracket bolts. I attached the sway bar end links. Now I'm going to put the plate up here, draw the subframe up slowly, and make sure that my rack bolts fall in place. Then I'm going to torque the subframe down, finish tightening the plates down. Then I'm going to tighten the rack bolts down, and I should be done. Good to go. It's good to get in alignment when you take all this stuff down, because you sure is going to knock your alignment off pulling this subframe loose. There you have it, folks. Everything is back in and tight. I did have to support the vehicle right behind these plates, which I typically don't like doing, but you got to take those loose. You don't have a choice. So, it's good to go. Ready to lower her down. If you feel that this information was useful, please like it and share it with your social media friends. You can subscribe to my channel so that you will get notifications of future videos that I post. You can follow me on Twitter, and if you need to contact me directly, please visit my website. And if you have any questions, leave them below, and someone or myself will reply to them. Again, thank you very much for watching.